Dear friends, welcome to another tutorial. In this tutorial, we learn how to use this small PIR sensor with Arduino. Let's start! In this video, we built a simple but very useful project. This project can detect movement of a person in an area. When it detects movement, it lights up the LED for a few seconds. Look, when I place my hand in front of the sensor, the LED lights up. Of course, in your project you can replace this small LED with a big one in order to light a room when motion is detected, or sound an alarm, or send an SMS to your cell phone, and so on. Let's now see how to build this project. Passive infrared sensors allow you to sense motion and are used to detect whether a human has moved in or out of the sensor range. If we remove the lens, we can see that PIR sensors use a pyroelectric sensor, this little sensor here, which detects infrared radiation that is emitted by objects. The hotter the object, the more radiation it emits. The sensor in a motion detector is split in two halves. When one half reads more radiation than the other, there was movement, and we can send a signal out to perform any action we like. The PIR sensor module we use today has three pins. This one is VCC, it is next to the protection diode. Next to it is the output pin, and the last pin is ground. If the module detects movement, the output pin goes high. The module also uses two trim pots. This one sets the sensitivity of the sensor, and this one sets the time that the output signal stays high when motion is detected. Let's now connect the module to Arduino. VCC goes to Arduino 5 volts. Ground goes to Arduino ground. And output goes to digital pin 9. Of course, you can use any digital pin you like. Next, we connect the LED. The positive leg of the LED goes to digital pin 13 and the other one to ground. Now we are ready to power on our project and see if it is working. Okay, we have to wait about a minute in order the sensor to stabilize, and then we are ready to use it. Okay, 30 seconds later, the PIR sensor has stabilized, and as you can see, it can detect the movement of my hand. Let's now go to the computer and see the software side of the project. The code of the project is very simple. We don't even need a library. All we do is to read the output pin of the PIR sensor all the time. If the output signal from the PIR sensor is high, we light up the LED, else we turn it off. As always, you can find the code of the project in the description of the video. That's how easy it is to connect the PIR sensor to any Arduino project. The low cost of it allows us to use it in many projects. What projects do you want to build with this sensor? Please post your ideas in the comment section below, and I will try to build as many as possible. Thank you very much for watching. Please consider pressing the like button if you like the video, or subscribe to our channel in order to watch our future videos as well. Thank you very much, and see you next week.